is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
My soul, there's no salvation in him as God. day long to meditate. But as we learned to have that word of God, and we were speaking to that word of God as God. And I became this man of your thought that happened to stop and never proved. For in the Bible, the Lord, thou art meant to be, O Lord, thy God. For so that never had any rejoicing when we gave my people shame in those men who made both those words against me. For I went into scourge my sorrows and tumor before me. For I will defend my people to now, they keep concerning my sin. But my enemies left from my swath and I, they repented and was they multiplied. They that bring me evil through the sign of each other to do goodness. For saving thou, O Lord, my God, depart not from me, be accepted much my help, O Lord of my salvation. For saving thou, the Lord, my God, depart not from me, be accepted much my help, O Lord of my salvation. O God, my God, unto thee I rise with thee long. My soul has thirsted for thee, how often I've heard flesh long yet, in my bearing and blood of washing. So in this section of him, before the deed that taught my glory. For thy mercy is better than lives under which I pray thee. So shall blessed be my life in the name of the Lord of my hands. At the throne of God is that my soul be filled with which rejoicing shall my mouth praise thee. If I never be on my bed, have gone and lived there, be thou become my helper. And the soul of them shall I rejoice. My soul hath pleaded unto thee, thou right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for these men that sought after my soul, they shall go down to the middle of the parts of the earth. They shall be surrounded and shed the sword, torches and boxes shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God, and worship your praise, and swear upon him, the mouth of them that stop and speak unjust things. At the dawn and at the end of the day, thou become my helper, and shall deliver me from the right choice. My soul hath pleaded unto thee, thy right hand hath been quick to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God, of my salvation, by day, by night, by night, Lord, let my prayer come to thee, God, now, and I give my salvation. For the good of the people is my soul, and my life, and the days have come after. And God, with them, they go down into the pit, and becomes a man who God called to grieve among the dead, like the bodies of the saints that sleep in the grave. With our English and warm, they are cut off from thy hand. They lead me in low spirit, in the darkness of the shadow of death. Against thee is my anger and strong, with all thy billows I sound by my foot. Thou hast removed my friend the Father, that he hath made thee an abomination unto himself. I have been delivered up, and have not been torn, my eyes are completely covered. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, the whole day long, I have stretched out my hands. Nay, the dead will not work on me. Shall physicians raise them up, and the enemy thinks unto thee. Nay, shall any of the grave of hell of them receive the pleasure that is burning. Shall thy wonders be known to that darkness, thy righteousness in that time that shall die? For that shall be unto the Lord, and my pride in the morning shall not bear it before thee. Wherefore, Lord, dost thou pass off my soul to those that face before thee? A poor man in troubles for my youth, had he been exalted, I was humbled and brought to his strength. Thy fears have passed upon me, and thy terrors are so troubled. They came not about my walk, all the day long they wanted to speak about me. Thou hast removed my bar from the turn of the my acquaintances and my O Lord God, my salvation by day and by night. us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of our Father, and for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good state of the Holy Church and of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and fear of God enter therein, for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate, and Christ, for the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States, also the clergies and current forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Adam, and Skyler, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for helpful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, brought deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Immaculate, most blessed, and glorious, and with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Shown us light, let us set it.
have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance are all holy, the Immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. God, Jesus, Savior. Both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all-holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God. Oh,
Christians, and send down upon us thy rich mercies through the intercessions of our all immaculate Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable body and his powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all honorable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers, among the saints, great hierarchs, and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra's Burden of Jerethus and Nectarius of Pentapolis, the winder workers of our fathers among the saints, Deacon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Myrrh Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the Hieromarchus Ignatius, the God Bearer of Antioch, Caranambos and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women, Martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fotini, Marina, Karis, Kiva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy, righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy martyr, Kalinikos of Gengra in Asia Minor, Holy Virgin Martyr Theodota of Bithynia, Pious Emperor of Theodosius the Younger, Constantine the Third Patriarch of Constantinople, Lupus the Confessor, Bishop of Troyes, and Martyr Serapia of Antioch, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
The fire died down, they found his body cold and unharmed. He entered the eternal kingdom in about the year 250. Theodotha, the Athenian, was a young widow with three children, a Thessalonica. Together with St. Anastasia, Theodotha labored in the work of God, completely dedicated to a pious life. The women were arrested during the time of Diocletian's persecution. At the trial, the dignitary, Lucadius, was captivated by the beautiful Theodotha, and he decided to take her home with him, intending to marry her. Theodotha kept herself in fear, the protection of the angel. He needed to inducements, nor charms, nor threats or assault by the king. Theodotha was sentenced to death, and together with her children, was thrown into a fiery furnace. Their holy souls soared into the heavenly father. On this day, we also commemorate Pius X, Theodosius the Younger, Constantine the Third, Patriarch of Constantinople, Lupus the Confessor, Bishop of Troyes, and martyrs Serapia of Antioch. By the intercession of the blessed angel of Christ God, have mercy upon us. Amen.
Thank you. that you'll be under with good things, and the rich at peace, and heavenly away.
More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Thou who without stain bearest not the word, and the truly veiled closely magnify thee.
Yes, the Lord is with me, and help to save me now, as he promised to our forefathers, Abraham and Lindsay, forever. Thank you.
sanctuary, praise the infinite thou of his glory. Lord, the Jews place thee in the grave by day, the soldiers guarded thee as a slumber, and as a treasure of life they sealed thee, but thou didst rise and granted corruptibility to our soul.
Praise him from his mightiness, praise him according to his excellent greatness. Thou give us thy cross, O Lord, as well by the feather gifts I owe us, who unable to behold his power, the fear.
Full moon as a
Thank you.
Amen.
and sing songs that thy name will glorify.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior,
proclaim thy mercy of God and thy truth by God.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Savior,
our God.
Lord, and God, God to thee be ascribed glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and ever, to the ages of ages.
Remember us, O Lord, when thou comest in thy kingdom.
call to the Corinthians, let us attend.
Brethren, we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field, God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and another man is building upon it. Let each man take care how he builds upon it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, or straw, each man's work will become manifest, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each one has done. If the work which any man has built on the foundation survives, he will receive a reward. If any man's work is burned up, he will suffer loss, though he himself will be saved, but only as through fire. Do you not know that you are God's temple, and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and you are that temple.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Beaten by the waves, for the wind was against it. And in the fourth watch of the night, Jesus came to them walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, "It is a ghost." And they cried out for fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take heart, it is I, have no fear." And Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, bid me come to you on the water." Jesus said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. But when he saw the mighty wind, he was afraid. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, "O man of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind became calm, and those in the boat came and worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." And when they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret.
Newborn.
Let us
of God, kindness is church. Name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Because they be quiet, so he bringeth them unto their desired haven.
Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. Well, this describes perfectly the events of that night. Gives us an idea of what Jesus was praying about that night up on the mountain before he went down to his disciples. And of course, this psalm was written some 800 years before this event. So this gives us a very good picture of God's foreknowledge and gracious intent in all things. The disciples thought they were doomed, but all the while they were in the palm of God's hand and were being watched over carefully by him, as he had foretold all those many centuries before. And when all was said and done and Peter had his little adventure on the water, it is said that those in the boat fell down before Jesus and worshipped him, saying, "Truly, thou art the Son of God." Okay, school's out. Lesson learned. Now you see why I can't be an earthly king. Now you see why there's something more important going on here than people getting their bellies filled. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could remember these kinds of things, really, every day of our own lives, where we thought beyond, you know, our bellies, our needs, the stuff that goes on in life, and not allow these things to blot out this wonderful knowledge that God is with us, that God foreknows all, that all is in his hand, that he controls everything, and that his mercy and loving kindness abides with us always. So often these things are blotted out by our day-to-day worries, our anxieties, our struggles, so far. You know, if we could remember these things, though, if we could remember the goodness and certainty of God's will and purpose toward us, not only would that remembrance give us peace during the bleak and stormy times of our own life, but I think it would go a long way toward helping us all be a lot less worldly in our thinking, in our perspective, in our choices. You know, if we believe that everything is in God's hand, everything belongs to God, then we would give ourselves to God and not hold back quite so much in our life, in our desires. You know, this would be a tremendous help to us. Because the one thing that we all fight, or should be fighting, we're not fighting it and we're overcome by it, but that is the secular mindset of this world from which we come, you know. Until this secular, godless mindset is changed by a proper spiritual formation over time, we remain not only in the world, but of the world in our thinking and even in our approach to God and faith. This explains, for example, the secular attitude explains why we so often compartmentalize life into different categories like family, school, hobbies, religion, as if these were all separate parts of a person's life, attended to individually or not at all. I mean, it's up to you, right? Are you religious or whatever? This is how the world views things. Everything separate, everything in its place, everything up to you. And therefore even sees religion as just one more elective that some people choose to add to their life. And I think the problem is that so many of us see it that same way too. Religion is, for many of us, just another of our little boxes that maybe in our case we're glad is there. Glad I have a religion box that I can go and visit in my life, maybe once a week. But beyond that, maybe we don't put much thought into it. We don't put much prayer into it. We don't put much time or certainly much money into it, because in our minds, to put too much into one box somehow causes the other boxes to suffer. That's kind of the way it is when you have this compartmentalized point of view. I have a life, and I have a certain lifestyle that I wish to maintain, and I can't pour all kinds of time and energy and money into church. You know, this is how a lot of people think. You have this view that is largely divorced from a Christian ethos. The secular pigeonholing of life causes us to forget one rather important thing, that Christ is our life. We don't just have life and then Christ added to it. we have Christ, we have life. Otherwise, we have no life. You know, it is perfectly acceptable, I think, in a secular mindset to perhaps live differently than what we confess. We say one thing but do something else. That fits with this idea of compartmentalizing life. Yeah, I'm a Christian, but you know, if I cheat a little bit at work or to advance my business or, you know, this kind of thing, well, that's business. You know, we've all seen in the movie where the gangster's about to rub somebody out, and he says, nothing personal, just business. That's so comforting to the guy who's about to be rubbed out. What am I talking about? You know, the secular life, I mean, I heard a guy describe it in this way, and I thought it was very interesting. It's obviously not all encompassing, but it gives you an idea. He said that this is a Christian man, and he says, I had a stomachache after going to a parishioner's house. Okay, he was a priest. A parishioner tried to poison him with some very spicy barbecue sauce. And he had a stomachache, and he had a service later that evening. So he said, I went to CVS and I picked up some antacids and I took the antacids and soon I felt better and I went to church. And he said, when I got to church, I realized it had never occurred to me to pray. Right? Because in the secular mindset, you take the pill and you get better. Cause, effect. You know, better living through chemistry, whatever you want to call it. But it's like, why didn't I think even just to pray to God or to help me, to strengthen me, to, you know, to relieve me, whatever. You know, it's like that came second. Thank God, I guess it was in there somewhere. And that's just a little example. I mean, obviously, it's a lot more than that. But in so many choices, we choose one thing over God. You know, it's like God is the afterthought. We pray after we've made the decision or made the move. That sort of thing. There's no Christ box in life. Religion box, home box, family box, Christ box. No. There's only Christ. And either we live in his box or we don't live at all. And this is why I think, you know, as Christians, we need to start giving some thought to this secular mindset, this idea of that causes us to divvy up our life, to make choices, to say, yeah, I'm Orthodox. But I don't go to church a lot because I'm busy, I've got stuff to do. No, it doesn't work that way. You can't make a confession and not live up to it in the Christian way. Or at least do your best to live up to it. You know, we don't have that ability to pick and choose that way. We must invest ourselves in Christ. You know, he puts it this way. And you think, maybe I'm being a little strict, I don't know. Maybe I'm not, but Jesus said, you gotta die. You have to pick up your cross, deny yourself, and follow me. And I'm trying to describe that illustration as, who is it that picks up his cross and walks? The condemned prisoner who's about to be publicly executed, right? Like Jesus. You pick up your cross and you take the walk of shame, and then they nail you to it and you die. This is what he's inviting us to do. Take up your cross. Join me in the green mile. You know, we're going to die together. But that's how you're going to live. That's the only way you're going to live. And we like those words, but we can fudge a little bit and say, yeah, but I'm not really going to die. I'm not really going to sacrifice. I'm not really going to put too much effort into it. I'm not really going to struggle to do my prayers every day and force myself to get over there. You know, this kind of stuff. You know, we compromise too much. Why? Because it's so much easier just to put everything in different boxes. I'll get to my religion box eventually. I'm sure I'm not doing a real good job of describing this, but I hope I'm at least giving you an idea of what I'm talking about. And this tendency that this way of thinking, this ethos, this mindset that we bring with us from the world into the church. And live by until we learn to correct it, until we pay enough attention to the Orthodox life that it begins to override that way of thinking and we see Christ in all. devote ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. This is the good thing. And I think, like the 12, perhaps, we need a renewed vision of the divine Jesus, the Lord and Master of all, Lord of my life, Lord of my business, Lord of my hobbies, Lord of whatever I do, that he, and in every way, in everything, we must expand that religion box until it becomes all-encompassing, our entire life. Jesus said, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and his righteousness, the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. And we know that, again, but is that the order that we follow, or do we seek all these things first and then pray to God at the end of the week? We just feel like we have to do these things ourselves and we have to take care of them, whatever. But putting Christ first and foremost in everything, in all of our decisions. Sacrificing, if need be, to put Christ first in our life and in our decisions will reform our secular mindset. You know, we are supposed to be in the world, but not of the world. But until we convert our way of thinking, we are both in the world and of the world. And this explains why it's so often so hard for us to fully embrace the Orthodox life. We need to change the fundamental way that we think about life so that Christ becomes all in all. This is what makes us fruitful branches. I am the vine, you are the branches. Abide in me, and I in you, and you will bear much fruit. And if we do not do this, then we become dead and withered branches cast into the flames. I don't want to follow that illustration too far, because it's scary. But we know that there's a certain and slow death to a secular thinking inside the Orthodox Church. It doesn't work. The way that we think must be reformed. And may God help us. Because it will be. You pay attention to what you do. You have a good and sincere heart. You try to press yourself and up your game more and more. God will convert you. Your thinking will change. And your habits and your life will change as a result. So, God help us. Glory to God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
That pardon always by thy mightiness, grant glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
and his kingdom, always now and ever and unto ages of ages. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin, Colleen and family, for Aaron, Wanda, Donald, Teresa, for Lucas and Ruth, for the Deacon Thomas and Wendy, for Kimberly, Ronnie, Andrew and Stephanie, the Deacon Theodore and Nancy, for Adrian and Ellen, and for the Deacon Jeremiah, for Nadia, Angela, Destiny, and Anna, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the newly departed Jim. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Our life.
blameless, blameless, peaceful, and the good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
And his soul, O Lord.
All your remembrance are all the immaculate, most blessed, and glorious name of the Lord, O Lord, and ever Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves to each other and our life unto Christ our God.
Right to him, to confess.
every place in thy sight. For thou art God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, every existing, eternally the same. Thou, thy only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit. Thou was, who didst bring us from non-existence into being. And when we have fallen away, didst raise us up again, and didst not cease to do all things, until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom, which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son, thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast vouchsafed to receive at our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and the thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring along, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and
Thank you.
Joseph, who do thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth. Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Calling to remembrance all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Precious gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loves mankind, receiving them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Precious blood, and through us unto all.
visiting with us this morning. The communion of the East Orthodox Church can only be served to those who are members in good standing of that body.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Thank you.
sinners who want remission of sins unto the Lord.
Worshipping the undivided Trinity, who
immortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Asking that this full day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
We give thanks unto thee, O Lord, who lovest mankind, benefactor of our souls and bodies, for that thou hast vouchsafed this day to feed us with thy heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make straight our path, establish all of us in thy fear, guard our life, make firm our steps, through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary and of holy saints. Thou art our sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us go forth in peace. Those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not who hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Please come forward for a blessing. I never know how to pronounce your last name.
Okay.
And which anniversary is this? 40. They were married when they were 10. On the day. Let us pray to the Lord. Servants Adrian and Ellen, who in thy loving providence thou hast deigned to unite together in holy marriage, and who rendered thanks unto thee today for the occasion of their wedding anniversary, for all the blessings bestowed upon them during the years of their marriage. Bless them always, O Lord. Fill their life with good things, and accept the crowns into thy kingdom, keeping them pure, blameless, and above reproach forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
our thanksgiving be acceptable before the majesty of thy glory, as a sweet aroma of incense, and as a holy offering. Grant us thy rich mercy and bounties every day. Deliver thy holy church and the city from all the assaults of every visible and invisible enemy. Grant that thy servants Adrian and Helen may live in health and without sin. Grant them advancement in every good thing, we pray thee, O most merciful King. Hear us and have mercy. Lord our God, who has espoused the Church as a pure virgin from among the Gentiles, continue to bless this marriage and reserve your servants, Adrian and Helen, in peace and in oneness of mind, as thou hast thus far since their marriage 40 years ago, and grant them the fulfillment of all their desires. Pour out upon them thine abundant blessings and mercies, for thou art a loving and merciful God. Grant them health, a long life, and success in all their good deeds, for thou art a good God who lovest mankind. And unto thee be ascribed glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the all-holy, life-giving Trinity, one is essence, one God and one kingdom. Bless you, Adrian. Bless you, Helen. And grant you a long life, prosperity, and faith. And he may bless you with an abundance of all good things on earth, and make you worthy to obtain the promised blessings through the prayers of the most holy Theotokos and of all the saints. Occasion of the 40th wedding anniversary, grant, O Lord, to thy servants peace, health, salvation, long life, and many years.
God, many years. God, many years. God, grant you many, many, many years. God, grant you many years. God, grant you many years. God, grant you many, many, many years. God, grant you many years. God, grant you many years. God, grant you many, many, many years.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The blessing of the Lord and his mercy be upon you through his grace and love towards man, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee. Through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all-laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of the venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Adam, of the holy martyr Callinicus of Gangra in Asia Minor, the holy virgin martyr Theodota of Bithynia, the pious emperor Theodosius the Younger, Constantine the Third, patriarch of Constantinople, Lupus the confessor, bishop of Troas, and the martyr Serapia of Antioch, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. On us and save us.